Connie, signed your new contract. You must be delighted to get it done.
Yeah, over the moon. I think there's been a lot of speculation, a lot of questions surrounding my future and what was going to happen. But like I say, over the moon to get it done, and I can now concentrate on playing football, playing well, and for Swansea, I need to keep on putting in the performances, because even though I've signed this contract, I think I need to keep on, like I say, playing well, and hopefully there's more to come from me.
Your contract's until 2022, so does that suggest that you see your long-term future with the club?
100%, obviously. Every player wants to play at the top level, and I think I'm a local boy, so to do it with Swansea, to get back to the Premier League where I inevitably want to play, would be brilliant. So I think the next few years now gives me a chance to stay in the team, hopefully keep on improving as a player, and hopefully the end goal is to, by the time that contract comes to an end, is be playing in the Premier League again.
Yeah, being a local lad, I guess it was an easy decision to make in many respects. Can you just tell us, you know, what does this club mean to you?
Yeah, it's huge. You know, I think ever since I was a young boy, and I grew up watching the Swans and watching players perform on the big stage as well. When I was in the youth team and stuff like that, it's brilliant to see. And now to see me walking out there with the likes of Joe and DJ and players who I've known since I was very young as well is brilliant. So that there's not many other clubs around this area, and obviously I was a rugby boy to start with, but once I was 100% committed to football, I think Swansea and Swansea City was the club for me.
You've enjoyed huge success since you made your debut in the FA Cup in January. You had those disappointing loan spells at Bristol Rovers and Middlesbrough, where you said you lost a bit of confidence and you didn't know whether it was going to happen for you. But now you find yourself in the first team at Swansea, in playing for Wales as well, playing for your country. It's been a remarkable ride.
Yeah, of course. As you know, it's a question that comes up a lot regarding me, and since I went to Middlesbrough and Bristol Rovers, etc., and didn't really do well, didn't get the games I needed, and I think obviously it's been a remarkable turnaround coming, playing for Swansea, playing for Wales now, and I think, as a lot of people say to me, you know, like, you can say you've almost made it, but in my brain, and when I speak to, you know, my family and my partner and people like that, it's just the beginning, hopefully, and I want to keep on playing well, keep on proving that I am good enough. Obviously, I've had a very good couple of months, and in my brain that has to continue if I want to have a good long career, you know. So at the moment, it's just about when I get the chance to play again for Swansea or for Wales is putting on good performances and showing fans and everyone else what I can do, and that I'm worthy of a place in the team.
So plenty more to come from you. Playing under Graham Potter, you feel you've developed quite a lot in the last few months?
Yeah, that was one massive positive when signing the contract. Obviously, we've got Graham Potter now, who has been brilliant since he's come in. He's a young manager with lots of great ideas, who trusts not only me, but the other young players in the squad. So I think that was a big positive, and like I say, I need to keep on proving to him that I am good enough, because let's not forget there's other players out there who are itching to play instead of me or get my place, so I have to keep on performing well and, like I say, showing him that I need to be playing week in, week out.
Yeah, I guess you see plenty of good things to come, and on a personal level, on a team level, in the next few years with Graham as manager.
Yeah, sure, we've got a lot of young players like myself who are hungry to succeed and do well for the team and for themselves. So I think if we can keep on pulling in the right direction, listening to what the gaffer and the staff have got to say, then why not? Who knows what we could achieve? You know, it's not set in stone that we're going to fail or succeed, but we have to work together, and whatever happens at the end of it, hopefully we'll be just all right.
And just on your role this season, I mean, you've been playing right back. We've seen you flying down the right a lot this season. You played right midfield or right wing, whichever way you want to put it, as well. One of your teammates said that you had the engine of a Ferrari. I won't tell you which one. Blushes, but I mean that's a big part of your game, Con, isn't it? That your stamina, your energy is a big feature.
Yeah, definitely. I think I've said it before. I'm not by a long way not the best player in the squad technically and that. So I have to work hard in training and when I play, and I think there's no substitute for hard work, as they always say. So ever since I was a little boy, my dad used to say to me, you know, you might not be the best player there, the best player on the pitch, but if you try harder than anyone else, then you're always going to have a chance. So I think I've taken that as well from Middlesbrough and Bristol Rovers, where I wasn't playing and I was working hard, and there were people asking why I wasn't playing, and I think there was always a question mark around that. So since I've come back and been playing for Swansea and for Wales, I think every time I play, just leave everything on the pitch, and if it's not good enough, it's not good enough. But thankfully so far, it's been okay.
I guess when you were watching the Swans as a fan back then, I mean, that was a big thing for you. When you saw footballers who give everything, they were probably the players that you liked the most.
Yeah, 100%. I think I was a mascot when I was about 8, 9 years old, and I always remember that down the Vetch Field, you know, walking out and seeing, you know, all the other eyes on me from the fans and stuff like that. So it's brilliant to be playing for Swansea, and like I say, hopefully it can continue in the future.
Yeah, it's a crazy one to digest, isn't it? Well, you were there in the Vetch Field, singing away, cheering on the players. Now you've got the supporters cheering you on.
Yeah,
what does that feel like?
Like I say, I've experienced a lot of different things as a fan at Swansea. You know, obviously I was a mascot back at the Vetch. I went to Wembley twice, and I remember watching the Cardiff game when we played them. We beat them 3-0 here at the Liberty, and I was sitting next to Lee Trundle, and to come from being there to being actually on the pitch, and them cheering me on is just unbelievable. And I thought, when I was a little boy, I never thought, it's the question you always get asked, is when you're going to play for the first team. And I used to turn around and say, it might never happen, you know what I mean? I have to hope and get a bit of luck along the way, and which I have. And now that's become a reality, so it's just brilliant to see.
Well, it's fitting, actually, that we do this interview in Landore, the home of the academy. Just if you tell me how big the academy has played in your path and in your career.
Yeah, it's been huge for me. Obviously, there's not that many staff around now that we hear from when I began. Obviously, I think there's John Gray, Guy Richards, who are the two that stick out in my mind, who have been here since I was, as long as I can remember. So obviously over recent years it's got a lot better standard of coaching, players, you know, facilities, etc. And obviously when I started, I was down the Elba playing fields, you know, on a, I think it was a Tuesday and a Thursday night, just turning up and trying my best and enjoying my football. And obviously things are a bit, I'd say, a bit more serious now. Obviously you've got academy status and all that, but obviously for them boys coming up and learning off great coaches like Waggy and like John Gray, is it's nice to see, and hopefully they can follow in mine and Joe's and DJ's footsteps in the future.
Yeah, the pathway is there now, isn't it? It's clear from the first team down, there's a pathway to the first team. The facilities here are incredible. Now we've got kids in the academy wanting to be the next Conor Roberts. That must be a crazy one to think about.
They must be mad. obviously, like I say, we've got brilliant facilities here at the academy now. We've got brilliant coaches, and I think having Graham Potter, a manager who has trusted a lot of young players this season, is almost an incentive for the young players. When I was little, and obviously the managers in the past who maybe weren't quite as keen to give young players a chance, they may have looked. I definitely looked and thought, like, this might never happen. You know, Swansea City in the Premier League, and as a manager who's not really trusting young players. But now we've got a manager and the facilities and other coaches and staff who are obviously backing the young generation, and hopefully, like I say, they can carry that forward, and the young players can keep on producing Swansea City first team players.